Osman here. This afternoon we're going to be talking about the installation of these newel posts. In the past we have used this newel post kit that is for, as you can see on the picture, for posts that we do to make them safe. But what happened is, in this case we're having the structure being underneath, will not allow us to put this type of fastener. We don't have enough preparation in the back. So what we're using instead to put these posts is another kit that is called key lock. And the key lock comes with a 9/16 bolt, and it has this little plate that we're gonna be inserting, and I already made my mark. This is my mark for my post. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna be inserting this piece right here just like that. And even though I'm not gonna be showing how to do it, you know, you scribe all this with your pencil, and then you secure it inside. This guy has to be a 16th of an inch below the wood. And then if you can see inside, it has this wedge. So this piece gets installed like this. And then this bolt gets installed inside the post right here, and then once it goes inside, it just locks like that. Well, anyway, I'm gonna do the second part once I do the routing part. Then once I have done that, that's gonna help me to start with my router. And then I have a trim router that I'm using for this purpose, and you see that bit is probably about 1/2 inch. Or yeah, about that. And okay, so now as you can see, we have done the part of the wood, and then we're putting our piece in. So a little bit of an 16th below, and this is the bolt that is gonna go. See, that's what I said. The hole being in there helps and it gives room for it to go in. It will stop at the center. But anyway, what we need now is just secure it, the four bolts, with the four screws, and then put the bolt in the post. Once I have secured, the next thing to do is to put center the post that is gonna go, and I'm gonna put a pilot hole with a 5/16 drill bit. I'm just gonna do a small pilot with an 1/8 inch, and then I'll go with the 5/16. So once you're finished putting the bolt, you leave probably like 1/2 inch to 3/8, and that's where it's going to go. And what I do is we're going to insert it in the hole. See how easy it goes. So once you put it in place, you can see it's gonna slide a little bit, and then you just go with it. Another post, and I just have one more left. Once we have installed the posts, we have cut all ready for height, and we have a piece of tape in which we have made the layout for the pickets. we have put a tape for the layout for the pickets, so we can mark where they're gonna go. And right now what we have on this one, we have made some pilot holes on that layout, and we have put already some bolts that are gonna hold the pickets. And this is our railing finished.